I think actually there are a few players that we use in the discussion here, but there are also from a general point of view of the question, what are you going to do with this space in the city, for example, space that's empty. I mean, you can occupy the space with the idea to set it as an example of how the city is leaving spaces empty as other people need these spaces to live or to work. But you can also squat this place as an artist collective in order not to make a political statement or make a political statement in one way, but also to satisfy your own need as an artist to have a space, which is, to me, a legal point of view. If you're an artist, you need a place.
Everyone, like
if you work, you need a place to live, or if you have an office, you need a building to have your computer in. And so I don't like the way that this discussion goes towards pointing at the artist and saying you're not making a political statement. I mean, okay, I think as an artist you should take responsibility. But you should also be able to work. So to me, both examples in Hamburg that were given, they're both completely all right. The one wants to make a political statement and does a good job on it. The other one wants to create space for artists and is doing a good job on that one. Mm-hmm. And the only thing that I think is that they shouldn't point at each other and say,
no,
you're doing it wrong. Work together.
No, I think the problem is more when the municipality puts artists, or this Camelot kind of business puts artists in a neighborhood to legitimize their own gentrification strategy and say they are going to pimp up the neighborhood because apparently the people who already live there for decades are not able to do
it.
Why do you care?
No, there's lots of reasons why we care about this.
Yeah, because we don't want to be kicked out because we don't have enough money to pay for rent, for example.
Because that's the end effect of it.
Artists in a squatter movement, sometimes, like, not just artists as such, but the whole idea that a space is used for cultural things, as well, like, within a neighborhood as a space for artists to work, or to have a party, or to, you know, for whatever reason, it can also legitimize, like, a squat being there. Because what else are you doing with a squat? Sitting there, living there? No, you have an idea with a squat. If you want to make a statement, you want to say, okay, this city doesn't have enough space for the cultural activities that we want to see, so we squat something and we DIY, we do it ourselves. That's the place of artists in
the squat. But even with squats, you don't leave the system, right? Like, just let me make that point clear. Like, if we are searching for enemies, for the number one enemy or something, like, be it bankers or artists or whatever, like, we cannot escape the system. Like, even in a squat, when you go to Albert Heijn, do your shopping, or like fill up the shelves and stuff, like wage labor as such, like any action you take, so many actions you take in this system contribute and reproduce the system. And so it's not necessarily artists, it's not necessarily bankers, because they would always go, hey, why? You do your work, and you try to make a living from this and that, and you follow that very capitalist logic of social mobility. You can try if you want, if you only try hard enough, and blah, blah, blah. This is a system, and everybody is part of that. It's not very helpful to always address a special group which is now the one that's the major target here, because we are all part of this and we would all need to stop with this.
I think it's exactly the same about the legitimation about the artists, for example, but also for squatters and maybe let's say bankers. They all have their own idea in their head that they are doing good and they are convinced about it. And they want to find legitimation in their surroundings. So it's for artists, they say, yeah, the things I make, it's so important, and I can inspire people, and you have to look at it. And I think it's the same with squatting. You say, look, it's empty and we need it, and use the space for everybody. And we are also going around in the neighborhoods to find legitimation for it. So, yeah.
But the thing is, you know, like using a group of artists as a tool of upgrading the neighborhood is something different, you know what I mean? Well, at least as far as I'm concerned, you know what I mean? If I go squatting and the artists, they have the art space, great, you know? But it's also about solidarity, it's also about creating social spaces, making a political statement, and it's not about upgrading the neighborhood, it's improving the neighborhood relationships, but not about fucking Sky making the, you know, like the NDSM, that all of a sudden everything is really skyrocketing because NDSM started it and now MTV moves in and it's all fancy schmancy, you know. And it's been in the pipe like this, it's in the West like this, it's everywhere like this. And you know, the thing is, to use a group of creative people as a tool to upgrade the market, that's wrong. And the thing is about squatting, it's not only about, it's also about creating spaces for creative people, but it's not only about this, sorry, as far as I'm concerned, it's also about showing solidarity to your neighbors, to create social spaces, to address the problem of social housing, and all of these things, you know what I mean?
That's all different, right? I mean, you have people coming together, claiming the space and doing what they think is right. And there's a lot of things nice about it, the solidarity, the maybe the cultural things or whatever that happens in it. Or the way that they plant a group of people there to fulfill their goals.
Exactly, yeah. On purpose, like that city beach there.
Yeah.
I want to say something positive about your documentary.
really. Didn't even get the critique,
because even though I'm not so fond of artists, whether they are squatters, anti-squatters, or in the social democracy legalized place, I think that your documentary really addresses the point of which, okay, as an artist, you have this kind of freedom, and that there comes a responsibility with that kind of freedom. And that you really show different kind of phases of that, and which provokes this kind of thought into also, I hope, into.
I think that the big question behind this is like, I mean, what is produced in the first world still? Like how do we work with what services? Like I said, Albert Heijn here, or like. I don't know what, like consumerism of all kinds, and it's culture, it's real estate, it's art, these kind of things. I mean, industrial labor has vanished to Southeast Asia, this kind of stuff, and here we need to find an answer. We need a redefinition of work. Basically, we were all redundant by now. Basically, like as technological innovation continues, and if we continue to define the value of a human being by its labor power, that's the crucial thing. Like if we don't need this, if it's done by machines and stuff, like what are we gonna do? I mean, of course, art is the answer for now, but like this is gonna end.
Why them?
This is gonna end. And this is going to lead to some serious disruption, I'm pretty sure, soon.
Anybody else has some...
It's a nice documentary.
Speaking about educating the mainstream public, I mean, did you already show the documentary somewhere to, like... we see either ourselves or our friends in this movie, and we know this story.
Yeah.
I mean, it's great to watch it, but... Are you thinking of places to show this film, or did you already show it on places and places where people are not so aware of this whole issue yet? Or
yeah, like I mean, like I was thinking, like maybe I can make it into television actually, like to really reach a wide public and stuff. I sent it to VPRO and Arte had connections. It's still not solved yet, but like these are options. Other than that, like I said, I'm aiming at the mainstream and like I'm aiming certainly at an activist, artist, but also a sort of ordinary resident audience. And I have been presenting this primarily so far. Oh, academic, I forgot.